Annalise, thanks for joining me again this evening. I've put together a little sleepy time yoga series for us just to wind down and get ourselves de-stressed, get some tension out of the body before we try to go to sleep or if you're trying to go back to sleep. As always, I don't have any music, so you can pick the kind of music that works for you, and I especially recommend that on this occasion because I won't be speaking as much as I typically do, so enjoy it while it lasts. Just start from a nice, easy seated position. You don't have to be cross-legged. Just sort of roll the shoulders up, back, and around. And then if you'll make little scoops with your hands, you'll just reach behind you and grab that fleshy part of your shoulder and just pull up and through with the pads of your fingertips. And so we're in the upper traps here where we carry quite a bit of tension. And I like to go up the sides of the neck using the heels of my hands. So I interlace my fingers and sort of squeeze the heels of my hands on either side of the neck. And again, just with the pads of the fingers, you can roll your fingertips across the base of the occiput, the occipital ridge, the bony protrusion at the base of the skull. Okay. Let's take one ear to one shoulder. It can be right ear to right shoulder or left ear to left shoulder, whichever works for you. You can help that along by pressing your opposite hand to the floor, or using your free hand to pull your ear close. Good, and to the other side. Just dip your shoulder over your opposite knees, open up the chest. Then let's take a twist, it doesn't matter which direction. To center, let's take a box twist, so one foot will be tucked in, the other foot will be tucked behind, the back hip will press up and forward and down and back. You'll feel the stretch on the front of the hip. Change sides. let's take the feet out wide. You can just walk yourself as far forward as you feel like you want to. Bring ourselves back up and take the feet together. We're going to reach forward for the toes. If you can, we'll take pigeon pose, but if you're already in bed or you have knees that are sensitive, it's better to lie on your back and take threaded needles. And just get the hips to open up a little bit. We'll cross an ankle over the knee if you're doing threaded needles and pull the knee into the chest. And let's swap sides. And if you're already on your back or in bed, you might like to just drop your knees from side to side like windshield wipers. If you are in pigeon or if you prefer, you could take a lizard and stretch out the front of the hips in a more intense fashion. Stretching out your hip flexors is the best way to relax the body and prepare for sleep, so it's a good thing if you are having trouble getting to sleep and if you're having trouble staying asleep. Let's all come onto the back and pull the knees into the chest, the thighs to the belly for a pasana. And if you like, you can just sort of roll side to side if you're on a hard surface. If you're already in bed, this probably won't feel good to roll around, but just pull the knees in as much as you can. And again, if you're already on the back, you can stay there, so everyone should be on the back, but it's hard to demonstrate for me to be on the back, so I'm going to come back up to seated. You can do that if you are doing this as a morning routine before you get out of bed, but if you're doing this as a nighttime routine to go to sleep, as the video is intended, you might like to stay on your back. So, didn't need to kick our little globe of light here, sorry. So, again, I'm never sure what you're seeing. Sometimes the image is flipped. So whatever it is that you're seeing, make sure that you put your left hand on the heart. So it's the opposite of what we would do for the pledge. And then once you have your left hand situated, you will take your right hand and put your thumb over your index fingernail, sort of like you're making the okay sign. The traditional way to do this is to hold your hand up by your shoulder, the palm facing out. If you're already, you can do that if you're lying down. If you're more comfortable, though, you can rest your hand on your knee or on your bed, palm facing up. And this is meditation for a calm heart. So you'll just close your eyes and deepen your breath. Swallow and relax your jaw, separate your teeth. And you'll breathe just a little bit more deeply than normal. You should feel the chest and the belly rising and falling. Be in and out through the nose, or in through the nose, out through the mouth, whatever works. If you're a more visual person, you might imagine that you are inhaling plus signs and exhaling minus signs, or breathing in hearts and exhaling hearts, giving and receiving, or sending and receiving love. Even more, so that you're feeling softer and heavier each time you exhale, releasing more and more tension, sinking deeper and deeper into the bed beneath you.